then the next day. It's very limited. He wants number one, but it's been knocked off by Roby. He's doing a lot of knocking off at the moment.
That's it.
Yes. Can he withstand that? The charge of Anderson Death. That's BJ and Duncan. And let's get ready to rumble. Is it always two singers? That says Colin Rice Kids. After watching them on Saturday night TV. 17-year-olds don't know, never heard of it.
There you go.
It's 20 years ago. Let's get ready to rumble. 99. What was it 20 years ago? What? Well, let's find out which one is. Supervised by professionals, of course. They're professionals here. Well, actually, now Vassos is here, so it's all right. Today's mystery guest, thank you, Vass.
Chris, I'm about to reveal today's mystery guest, after which you'll be required to conduct an interesting, stimulating, and if it calls for it, humorous 3-minute interview without any prior knowledge of the subject. Good luck, my friend.
Thank you.
On Friday, former teacher turned chocolate maker Richard Carver got in touch to big up the Ramsbottom Chocolate Festival. This tickled the team's taste buds, and to be honest, they don't need much of an excuse to talk about
the syllabus, and then they wrote me a new one. So, you know, to be honest, chocolate is a very complex industry, and the principles of which are quite simple, but I think you can learn so much about chocolate now from the internet. And I work with a company called Barry Calabang. They've got hundreds and hundreds of videos, bits of information for anyone who wants to find out how to make chocolate at home.
Yeah, as a kid, I used to suck the chocolates to make them last longer, but as an adult, I found I'm crunching the board. It's opened up the calories on there far too quickly. Any advice on this?
Okay, well, the way we take chocolate is actually quite simple. Grab your nose, grab both nostrils, put the chocolate into your mouth, chew it or suck it for a couple of seconds, and then open your nose, breathe in, and what that will actually do is separate. You've already melted the chocolate in the mouth, and then you take it in, and it allows you to get the full flavour, and it's how we professionally taste the industry.
Unlike wine, is it advisable to spit it out afterwards?
No, actually, a lot of chocolate later flavour notes, because of the way that chocolate is, it takes quite a while to break the process down on the palate.
So you have to swallow it.
Absolutely, of course.
Right, Lewis, this is another great chocolate today. Thanks for being on our program. And of course, we must play D, because three of us are here after that. 13 to 9, I think Carl Vornable's on the show next. What's happened to her nose?